Wait, give me 10 seconds. What's up, everybody? I'm Tan Panda, here with BarbecueChickenRobot.com. We're bringing you another episode of Blurs. We're here at the Hippleton Gallery in downtown Fullerton. And I'm very excited to introduce our special guest today, all the way from Chicago, the Company of Thieves.
Woo! Hi, thanks for having us.
Yeah, thank you so much for coming out and being here with us today. Why don't you just introduce yourselves before we get things started?
Okay, I'm Genevieve, and I'm the vocalist.
I'm Mark, I play guitar.
And I'm Mike, I play drums.
Okay, well, last night we got a chance to see you guys play in Hollywood, and I had so much fun. You guys were awesome. I know that you guys have been touring for the last 2 months, and you guys are finally going to get to go home. Can you tell us a little bit about what touring was like?
It was really our first time ever touring for more than like 3 weeks, and going from 3 weeks to 2 months is, you know, a big step, but it was great. I think everyone adapted to it really well. We learned a few things, you know, really quickly, like how to try to keep our immune systems up. Like, everyone got a little sick in the beginning, but it was great. I think we all got to see places that we've never seen before. And
what place do you think has shown you the most love?
Oh, man.
It's hard.
Salt Lake City, Utah was crazy.
Yeah.
LA was really crazy.
That was great.
Yeah, I heard that LA was the first show in California that you guys
ever. I was so nervous, but it ended up being great.
That was like an awesome turnout.
Well, hopefully it's not your last. Yeah.
No.
Can you tell us a little bit about how the band formed?
Yeah, actually, we were, around 18, 19 years old, and just sort of like taking care of ourselves in the city of Chicago. And they were in school, I was working, and we happened to meet through a mutual friend at Union Station in Chicago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, kind of one thing led to another, and we started hanging out and writing songs, and
it was perfect because all of our bands that we were previous in just broke up at the same time. Mm-hmm. So we kind of just like all fell into place together at the right time.
Yeah, we hit it off when we met each other. So we started hanging out and writing music. And then one day I was just searching through a local paper and I found an open mic advertisement at a coffee shop in the city. And I was like, let's go, let's play a song, you know? And it kind of started there. And we played open mics and built up like a singer-songwriter community that was supporting us. And then we met Mike. Actually met him or bumped into him at Union Station as well. Mm-hmm. And his band had just broken up and I was like, I'm in this crazy new project, like, listen to this right now. And I gave him the headphones. I'm like, could you do anything with this? And he's drumming on. He's like, I could see what could fit with this. You know what I mean? Yeah. Everything was just so, it was almost like it was supposed to happen.
That's awesome. Tell us about your album, Ordinary Riches.
Basically it was just a bunch of songs we put together on accident, pretty much, you know. And we had a bunch of missing puzzle pieces we kind of fit together, and just was kind of like an experiment because we were never songwriters in our previous bands. We just wanted to do it because it felt right, and we had the opportunity to record with Sean O'Keefe, which is a well-known producer in Chicago. And he was on the same page with us on in terms of production style and how we want to arrange the songs and how we want them to sound. And it worked out perfectly because we knew that it wasn't going to be some guy who was going to try to change what we were trying to do into a different direction. And it ended up being something very special to us. We recorded it about 2.5 years ago, and we were touring on a much smaller scale on it, you know, just weekend trips and stuff like that. And now it got picked up and nationally released, and it's still relevant to a lot of people and still relevant to us. So it's really cool to see how it's still fresh. And it's something that is 2 years history for us, but we're still proud of it, and we're looking forward to still grow on that, and we're writing some newer songs. And
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's awesome. I think I'm going to go ahead and get out of your way. So without further ado, the Company of Thieves.
Woo! Thanks. Hi, we're Company of Thieves, and this is called Oscar Wilde. Shut style. This song is from an acoustic EP that we released this summer, and it's called When the City Waves, You Must Learn to Swim. I somehow realized that I was using it all. Realized that I shit out of luck, sitting on doorsteps waiting for you. this song is called The Fire Song.
For coming out, that was a lot of fun.
Thanks for having
thanks.
Us.
Thanks. We had fun.
Yeah, so look out for their album. It's titled Ordinary Riches. You can check out more music on companyofthieves.net. Special thanks to the Hibbleton Gallery. Check them out at hibbleton.com. And until next time.